It is the digital equivalent of the dilemma of the chicken and the egg, which came first, okay? Right? And it is as confusing as that. The reason it's called bootstrapping is it comes from an old tale of literally pulling yourself up by your bootstraps. So the ways in which you'd actually get something started is you'd pull yourself up with your bootstraps. And that bootstrapping sequence is the thing that starts that process. One of the hardest bits of doing computing is you ultimately have to recognize there comes a moment when you can't understand it all. You can't understand the thing that you're building is so complex that it doesn't all fit in your head, okay? That's the hardest and most difficult moment I've ever faced, and it's the bit that everybody kind of doing computing struggles with. Happened to me when I learned about compilers, okay? Now, compilers are the things which take the programming languages that we have and translate that programming language into the sequence of instructions that run at the chip on the computer. Okay, so they go all the way from the kind of high-level language like Java down to the machine codes that you might be running on. Here's where it kind of gets difficult, and this is where you're going to have to bear with me on this one. And it is the digital equivalent of the dilemma of the chicken and the egg, which came first, okay? Right? And it is as confusing as that, okay? So, you will write something in a language. Let us say, for example, you write something in one of the languages we would use would be Java. And you write things in Java, and it has a particular style of writing. If statements, a whole set of things. But how did you start? Where did the first language come from? And how did you get there? It is that moment of complexity that it almost feels like magic, okay? Because it works, and it takes you a while to figure out why it works, and it feels quite elusive. Bootstrapping is a means by which we can allow our software systems to exist independent of the machines that they run on. Without things like bootstrapping and without compilers, you'd essentially have to rewrite programs and replicate all the instructions for every machine that you'd ever build, okay? Or every family of machines. So if everything stayed at the level of ones and zeros and flicking switches, you'd have to have a different sequence of flicking switches for every machine that exists in the world. And that gets tiresome at best, but virtually impossible given the complexities and the size we've got.
Why would that be the case, Professor? Because if the same computer has been made twice at the Apple factory, aren't all the circuits exactly the same and everything exactly the same? So wouldn't the language that worked on computer A still work on computer B?
That would potentially be okay. But then let's put in a PC made by multiple manufacturers and multiple sorts of manufacturers. But then let's think about that same program running on another machine or another architecture. So that would also mean that every program that you'd make or run would have to be rewritten when you bought your next machine or they changed or upgraded it. So it becomes incredibly complex to do this and incredibly complex and frankly, feels just a little bit dumb.
Yeah.
Right?
Okay.
So something better's needed than that. And what happened in computing is this notion of what was called high-level languages got developed. And high-level languages are languages which free you from the monotony of those switches and free you from thinking in ones and zeros and let you think in a more abstract way, okay? And the abstraction that's applied here is often, for anyone who programs, is fairly familiar. It's if statements, it's iteration, so these are the means by which we think of our programmers. So our programmers now write in these languages and they don't ever really have to think about what those things run on, okay? They simply need to think algorithmically on those languages. You need to find a way of expressing that higher level language and mapping that higher level language to the ones and zeros that drive your machine. And a number of people built a sequence of systems that did that. People looked at that and thought, now, we're writing programs here in this higher level language, and those programs can do mostly anything. One of the things that those programs in this higher level language could do, if you wrote them, is they could actually do that translation. They could, written in that higher level language, actually do the translation from the higher level language to the lower level language. The next step, once you've done that, is you can identify a small core subset of a language that represents the very kernel starting point to let that process happen, okay? So that small, tiny, and the tactic here is to make that the smallest that you possibly can, okay? So that small, tiny kernel is the starting point for you to be able to compile and run a program. And then that can compile and run the compiler that can let you do a bigger and bigger set of languages. And so what's now happened is you've got this small program that if you translate that small program from one machine architecture to another, okay, that will then run those other programs, translate those other things, and then everything that's ever been written in that higher level language can run in your new machine.
So the only thing that has to be adapted from machine to machine is this little tiny nugget,
and that process and that little seed, and the means by which you then pull those other things over to let everything run is called the bootstrap, and it comes from the phrase pulling yourself up by your bootstraps. And that bootstrap process is the bit that does the translation from one machine to another. So that kind of nugget or nut or central point is the bottom, it's the base level for all these kind of towers of abstraction, okay? And in operating systems, that often gets referred to as the kind of kernel. So in operating systems, it would be the thing that touches the hardware. So it would be the thing that puts things in and off disks, would be the things that speaks to various displays. And so those are, that kernel is the kind of starting point for it. So bootstraps is the principle by which you do this. Kernels is the way it works, is the particular name given for that sequence in some operating systems. There are particular standards applied in it, and it's done in particular ways. Actually, one of the things that's really interesting is what goes in there stays in there, okay, and it stays in there forever because it's hard to change that level of coding. Most developers had to read 600 pages per day of change requests before they could do any coding.
That's called popping the stack.